Hello everyone, myself Professor Sudarshan Patil. So today we are going to study about moment distribution method. So moment distribution method is one of the simplest method to analyze statically indeterminate structures. So already you have studied about the determinacy and indeterminacy of the structure. So just I will brief it. So indeterminate structures means if number of unknowns are more than number of equilibrium equations. So this type of structures are called as indeterminate structures. So remember, this moment distribution method is also called as relaxation method. So it was developed by Hardy Cross. So this is a brief introduction about moment distribution method. So in short form we call it as MDM. So moment distribution method. So you can see, to develop any theory there are certain assumptions. So while developing the moment distribution method, there are certain assumptions which are made. So those assumptions are like this: all the members of the structure are assumed to be fixed, and fixed end moments due to external loads are calculated. So generally this moment distribution method is suitable for any type of structure, such as continuous beams or framed structures. But you can see, in case of continuous beams, the intermediate members are also considered as the members having fixed supports, and based on that we are going to calculate fixed end moments. So now you can see, second one, all the hinged joints are released by applying equal and opposite moments. So generally you can see that joints are balanced by applying equal and opposite moments. So third one, you can see the unbalanced moment. So if the joints are having unbalanced moment, it is shared by the member connected to that particular joint. So we will see in an example further, you will be able to understand this later. So last point, you can see the unbalanced moment at a joint is distributed in two spans with respect to their distribution factors. So in third point, they said that unbalanced moment is distributed to the adjacent joint. So in fourth point, they say that unbalanced moment at a joint is distributed in two spans. So how much amount of moment is distributed to one span and how much amount of moment is distributed to other span is depending upon their distribution factor. So what is this distribution factor, what is unbalanced moment, and what are the terminologies which are there in moment distribution method, we are going to study further. So you can see the terminologies which are related to moment distribution method. So the first and a very important terminology is carry over moment. So what is this carry over moment? So when we apply certain amount of moment at one end of the member, allowing its rotation, means we are not fixing that member. Allowing its rotation means we are not fixing that member. So I will repeat, when we apply certain amount of movement to one end of the member, allowing its rotation of that end, and if other end is fixed, far end means opposite end. So if far end is fixed, some amount of movement also develops in the far end. So this is far end. So some amount of movement also develops in the far end. So that developed moment is called as carry over moment. Just I will represent it with one example. So let us consider a beam. So it is a proper cantilever beam having span AB of length L. So we are applying some amount of moment at point A, that is capital M. So when we apply some amount of moment at capital A, small amount of movement will be transferred to the far end. So you can see A is a near end now. So near end to near end we are applying the movement. So B is a far end. So to the far end some amount of movement is going to get transferred. So that amount of movement we are going to mark it as M dash. We are going to mark it as M dash. So here M dash is called as carry over movement. M dash is called as carry over movement. So I hope you had understood about the carryover moment. So now, what is carryover factor? So this carryover factor is in generally It is a ratio of carry over moment, means m dash to the applied moment. So m dash divided by m is a carry over factor. So generally carry over factor will be half in most of the cases, means half of the moment, half of the applied moment will be transferred to the far end in most of the cases. So this is a second terminology. So third terminology is stiffness. It is a very important terminology which you need to understand properly. So stiffness is denoted by small k. So stiffness is nothing but movement required to rotate an end by unit angle when the rotation is permitted. So same example I am going to take. I am going to take span AB, which is having length L. So at near end, means at A, we are going to apply the movement M. So this movement is trying to rotate this particular end by the angle theta A. So you can see here, if this end is roller supported, so movement is allowed, movement is not restricted at this particular end. So I hope you are having knowledge about the restriction of a movement or not. So you can see hinged end and roller ends are having no restriction to movement, but fixed end is having restriction to movement. So it is not having any restriction to movement. So it is rotating this particular beam by angle theta, So you can see stiffness of that beam is calculated by M divided by A. Actually stiffness is a moment required to rotate an end by unit angle. But you can see, let us think that I have applied 10 kilonewton meter of movement and it is rotating the end A by 5 radians. Means K is equal to 10 divided by 5, means 2. So 2 is a 2 kilonewton meter is a movement required to rotate by unit angle. So that's why K is equal to M divided by theta A. So how to calculate this K? Calculation of this K is very important. So for the continuous beams, remember this, for the continuous beams, stiffness of all intermediate beams, is equal to 4, K is equal to 4 EI by L. Stiffness of all intermediate members. Now stiffness of edge members. So if edge members, having fixed support, so K will be given by 4 EI by L if it is fixed support. But if it is hinged or roller support, if the end members are having hinged or roller support, so we are talking about far end. So we need to consider about a far end only. So if edge supports are fixed, 4 EI by L. If edge supports are hinged or roller, it is 3 EI by L. So remember these formulas. These formulas are very important. Now where E is equal to modulus of elasticity or Young's modulus, I is equal to moment of inertia of beam, L is equal to length of beam. Okay, so this is about the stiffness of the beam. So stiffness is nothing but movement required to rotate the end by unit angle, that is 1 radian. So these are the formulas you need to remember. We'll move further. Another important terminology in moment distribution method is distribution factor. So you can see this distribution factor is a very important terminology. Based on this distribution factor only, we are going to distribute the movement to the far ends. So what is this distribution factor? I will tell you. When a movement is applied at a joint where number of members are meeting, for example, say 4 members are meeting, the applied movement is shared by the members meeting at that particular joint. So you already know. So based on carryover factor and other things, so meeting at that joint. So the ratio of movement shared by the individual member to the total applied movement at that joint is called as distribution factor. So I will just show you a diagram. You can see there is a joint O to which 4 number of members are getting connected, that is D, A, C and B. So OD, OA, OC and OB. So we are applying movement M at joint O. Suppose movement carried by the joint A is, moment carried by joint A is MOA. Means what is distribution factor? Distribution factor is moment carried by individual member divided by total moment applied. So moment carried by the individual member OA is MOA divided by total moment applied is capital M. So this is about distribution factor. Now expression for distribution factor. So distribution factor is very simple. So distribution factor is equal to K divided by, means stiffness of individual member divided by summation of stiffness of all the member. I will tell you how I have arrived to this. So you can see already we have studied that distribution factor is nothing but moment carried by individual member divided by total moment. And this distribution of moment is depending upon distribution factor. And that distribution factor is depending upon stiffness of the member. So that is why we can say that this distribution factor can be distribution factor of individual member can be calculated by using this formula. So stiffness of that particular member divided by sum of stiffness of all the members meeting at that particular joint, meeting at that particular joint. So this is briefly about the basics of moment distribution method. Further, you can see procedure to solve the examples. So this is very simple. So first step in the procedures is consider individual beam from a continuous beam. So from a continuous beam, we have to consider an individual member and assume it as a fixed, and we need to calculate fixed end moments. So I have the formula list for this fixed end moment further in next pages. So we need to calculate fixed end moments. Next, you can see second step is calculate the distribution factors for all the members meeting at a joint. This is very important. So we need to calculate the distribution factors for all the members meeting at that particular joint. Now balance a joint by distributing balancing moment. If the joint, if a particular joint is having unbalanced moment, we have to balance it by assigning it with a negative sign. To the various members meeting at that particular particular joint proportional to the distribution factor. So what this third point says is, so at a particular joint, if there is an unbalanced moment, that unbalanced moment we have to assign with a negative sign, and we have to distribute that unbalanced moment to the far ends meeting at that particular joint, or to the members meeting at that particular joint. So how we are going to distribute it? We are going to distribute it in proportional to their distribution factors. Now fourth one, you can see carry over the half of the distributed moment to the far ends. So we need to carry over half of the distributed moment to the far ends. Next, repeat third and fourth step until and unless distributed moments are negligible. Next, last point, you can see we have to repeat this third and fourth step until and unless this distributed moment should be negligible, means it is 0.05 or 0.005, like that. So last point is sum up all the moments at particular end of the member, and it is going to give us the final moments. So I hope you had understood. This is about the theory of moment distribution method. So in next session we are going to study the examples on this moment distribution method of continuous beams.